There are many things done which are practiced by tradition, basically getting together and reciting Quran and making dua for the benefit of a person, whether dead or alive. So, is that according to the sunnah? And if it is not, what is the best way to, in a sense, when we experience death in the family or after the burial?
This is very easy because a lot of these things happen in our lives, and a lot of those who are around us make what is known as khatam, or they mourn the dead for 30 days, or do things like congregational dua, gathering on the third day of the burial, then on the 14th, and then after 1 year. And then they ask, these are our customs and traditions. And we say, okay, are these things related to religion? They said, what do you mean? I said, reading the Quran is religious. Giving the thawab, the reward of the Quran, is a religious concept. Making dua in congregation is a religious concept. So, any of these things, do we find any traces of them in the Sunnah? Did the Prophet alayhi wasallam ever directed us to do such things, or the companions, or the tabi'in, or the tabi' tabi'in? The answer is definitely not. So if it is not, we cannot associate it with religion. This is part of other customs and traditions of other religions. The issue of 40 days after the burial is coming from the pharaohs of Egypt, who used to believe that on the 40th day of the burial, the dead will rise and they will eat and drink. This is why they put food and drinks and their rides and the jewelry next to them. This is what they believe. Unfortunately, the Muslims are doing this. So all of this is haram. Congregational dua is an invitation. You love the one who had died, you love your deceased, make a lot of dua on your own, in sujood, before salam in prayer, between adhan and iqamah, when it rains, at the last third of the night, raise your hands and say, oh Allah, forgive my uncle, forgive my cousin, fill his grave with light, on your own, between you and Allah. There's no problem in that. You want to go for another level? Give charity, sadaqah. Okay, I'm going to print copies of the Quran in Rohingya, and I want this to be for my deceased. I'll print 1,000 copies. How much? Here you go. This will remain continuous sadaqah jariyah for your deceased. You have something a little bit more? Come to Saudi Arabia, come to Papa, come to make Umrah, come to make Hajj. If you had made
Inshallah. Yeah.
Umrah and Hajj for yourself, make them for your deceased. This will go directly. Making citations of the Quran doesn't reach him. Offering Sunnah prayers, voluntary prayers on his behalf doesn't reach him. And the likes, and Allah Azza wa Jalla knows best.
Alhamdulillah, we have reached the end of our third session of the conference. Please keep on sharing any pearls of wisdom that you have gained throughout the session on your social media with the hashtag TSP2021 Be Steadfast. We do have some live polling session going on in our Telegram group chat. So if you are in it, please do participate in our polls. Our fourth and final session tomorrow, which is on the 28th of March 2021, will begin at 2:30 p.m. Malaysian time, inshallah.